It's your boy, AB. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Trolling at its finest. Or yet again, cashing out at its finest. AB has, he DM'd Eddie Hearn. As you can see, the message, as you can also see in the video, it says, listen, man, give me 20 million. I will make 135. And knock Devin Haney the fuck out. That's AB sending it to Eddie Hearn. I originally, you know, first when I thought about it, I was like, you know, why is Eddie doing this? That's petty of him. And, you know, because Eddie doesn't know how to, you know, I'll keep it a buck. He's my boy, but he doesn't know how to keep his mouth shut. And this was, it was funny. I thought it was hilarious. But then I'm like, damn, why is he violating AB when AB is literally like, is in his worst face right now. You know what I mean? Like he has like personal issues that, like I said, I'm not going to discuss about because that's not for me to judge him. But, you know, I know he's having some money issues, you know, settlements and whatnot. But I was reading the comments. People were like, Eddie, you know, you're petty for this. Like, why would you do that? Like, keep this personal. But as many of you might remember, might not remember, when the Zone first launched and Eddie was looking for talent to sign, you know, to have enough talent to put on the broadcast of the Zone, AB posted the email, I believe, about the multi-fight deal, and he said that Eddie was lowballing him. So, you know, AB did start the exposing Eddie Hearn, and, you know, Eddie Hearn ended up exposing him at the end. You know, he's having the laugh right now. But other than that, right now, AB and Devin Haney are going at it. For many years, I recall a couple events. I know they've been really cool. They're tight. You know, it was mutual. Like, you know, there was no really beef going on. And now it seems like AB has a problem with Devin. You know, a couple years ago, AB was the next Floyd Mayweather. You know, he was always with Floyd. Floyd would look after him. Consider him like a legit little brother, you know. And I think AB knows, like, you know, what he once had, he lost it, and he can never get it back. You know, unfortunately, you know. And Devin Haney right now, he's at his peak. He's, you know, now he's a former world champion. He's an injury. He's been associating himself with Floyd a lot, and I don't know if I don't know if Devin Haney is clout chasing or Floyd, or, you know, I think Devin Haney is just trying to better his brand, you know. And there's nothing wrong with hanging out with Floyd, because AB did it once too when he was coming up, and everybody seen him as the, you know, next big thing. But, you know, AB can only blame himself for his, you know, he can only blame himself for not becoming what he was supposed to be. You know, this is, you know, AB's left with what ifs, what ifs, what ifs. Devin Haney still has that potential to become greatness, you know. And even Devin, you know, like I said, these last couple of hours, days, Devin and AB have been keep going back and forth. Devin Haney has, like I said, Haney has been doing his own thing. He's, you know, Devin also has been mentioning about, I think he was writing this on Twitter or IG, he said he wants to fight AB at a catchweight. And then with this DM from AB saying to Eddie that he'll fight him at 135, as long as you give him a 20 million, Devin responded with the, you're selling yourself out. Like, you know, you're pricing yourself out too low or whatever. Like, you know, like I said, I don't know AB's situation. AB has had like a year, you know, it's been an erratic year for him. Like, he had a good fight with, not, I want to say good fight with Pacquiao, but he had a good payday with Pacquiao. He's claimed retirement. He's claimed he's broke. He has settlements, and I'm just really not too sure what's the future for AB. He's talking about coming back. He needs the money. He's talking about that he wants to beat the crap out of Devin Haney because he hasn't paid, you know, he hasn't paid his taxes yet. And, you know, he's lit, and he wants to make noise. And like I said, I don't blame a man for trying to make a fight and set a price, you know what I mean? But we're going to come to a reality where, are you really worth the $20 million? Or is this fight even a fight that people want to see? No, it's, you know, if you would have told me about AB and the Devin Haney today, you know, let's say, for example, if AB had two losses and you know, had some credible wins or some big wins in his resume, then the fight would be big. Like, is this fight still entertaining? Fuck yeah, it's entertaining. I would love to see it. I would love to see the AB trash talking. You know what I mean? Like, it would be fun to just see the build up to it. The one thing I give AB props that a lot of these boxing fighters don't have nowadays, he knows how to sell a fight. He knows how to promote. He knows how to just make headlines. That's what he's known for. And I think that's what keeps him relative. And I respect AB in terms of, as much as we clown him, we bash him for losing to the most important fights. You know, we bash him because he loses fights that are meaningful. You know, the losses that he has, you know, he could have, you know, we expected more from him. We expect him to win some of them, you know. Or, matter of fact, we expect him to win all of them. But, you know, AB is his own demise, but I can never take away from him fighting the best. You know what I mean? AB has a fucking resume of fighting the elites, and I can never take that away from him. And, you know, is this fight demanding enough for Eddie Hearn to pay him 20? I mean, you know, if he's paying AB 20 and he's not even his part of his stable, imagine how much maybe Devin's asking. Who knows? Maybe Devin saying, you know what, give AB more. I'll give him a beating. I don't know. But Eddie Hearn's having the last laugh. He's exposing AB. He's seen, you know, he's taking advantage of AB at his worst when he's most vulnerable. It's you know, Eddie makes it sound like in other words, AB is begging for this paycheck. You know, he needs to fix his, you know, he's begging and whatnot. But, you know, this is a great technique, a great way to start getting people to talk, just like me. I'm making this video to start talking about this shenanigans or this news. But like I said, AB hasn't fought in 135, what? 2013, because I remember he moved to 35, and then he moved to Paulie at 47. Yeah, AB is inconsistent, like, in terms of AB's big when he's not fighting. Like, huge. He's like a big 180. I could, you know, when I see him, I'm like, yo, this dude is big. High 80s, 190s probably. But, like, so I don't think, you know, he's wilding. If he's just 135, man, he's gonna get, I think he'll get knocked down, man. But all that weight training, cutting down that weight, that's a lot for him, you know what I mean? He barely, you know, even with the 140, I think he was having trouble making 140. That's why some fights he was fighting catch weights 44. You know, he fought a couple times 44 and a half, 44, 45, whatever. But what you guys think, man? Eddie Hearn's having the last laugh. He exposed Adrian Broner. You know, AB and Devin Haney are going at it. It's crazy, man. What an odd day of boxing, man, with these news. But, hey, it is what it is. Comment down below what you think about AB and Haney. Do you think that fight's going to happen? How much do you think Hearn should offer AB for a fight like this? And, you know, will we ever see AB return in the ring? Let me know, guys. Your boy AB. Peace.